What's up YouTube, JP here, and in this video we're going to take a look at the Steam Deck. We're going to look at which model I went for, and then we're going to upgrade the storage. So, without further delay, let's dive in. So some of you might remember that I actually had a Steam Deck before when it first came out, but I found that the software was very buggy and the performance wasn't great. Well, after some time, the Steam Deck received plenty of updates. It's no longer as buggy and the performance has got a lot better. Now, that's not really what we want to talk about in this video. It's all about storage. So the model I went for is the 64GB. To be honest with you, if Steam actually offered a Steam Deck with no storage, I would have gone for that option because I believe 64GB is a bit of a waste of time. It's eMMC and it's really slow, and some of the games that I play won't even fit on 64GB, let alone the 40GB that you're left with after the Steam OS is installed. Now, looking at the prices of the Steam Deck, the 64GB is £350 here in the UK. And I thought, that's a pretty reasonable price. What isn't reasonable is the £560 for the 512GB. Yes, you get more storage and it's faster, and you get one of those anti-glare screens. So that's an extra £210 to get the one with the 512GB storage. So I thought, well, I'm a bit of a tinkerer, as you know, so I thought I'll upgrade the storage myself. All models of Steam Deck do have a 2230 M.2 slot. So it doesn't matter if you get the 64GB, you can go out, buy a 512, 1TB 2230 M.2, and just upgrade it. There's actually only 12 screws that we need to take out to change the M.2 storage drive. That's the 8 on the back, the 3 on the metal little heat shield thing that covers the SSD and a few other components, and then the screw itself that holds the M.2 in place. Now, you do need to be aware that it has to be a 2230. I know some people have put a 2242 in there, but I wouldn't recommend that. You've got to remember that this drive here is the actual size of the 2230. This is the original 64GB eMMC that came in my original Steam Deck. So now I have two of these things I don't need. So recap, I got myself a Steam Deck, the 64GB model. I then went out and got a 512GB Western Digital NVMe Gen 3 2230 SSD. Now, I managed to source the replacement SSD for my Steam Deck for about £40, $45, $50, something like that. Yes, it's pre-owned, but it comes with a 2-year warranty. Now, you are going to need a few things to actually do this process. Obviously, you'll need a Steam Deck and you'll need the replacement NVMe SSD. But you're also going to need something to put the Steam OS on so you can put it back on the Steam Deck. So you're going to need a USB stick to re-put Steam OS on the Steam Deck. Now, I would recommend a USB-C style one like this Kingston 64GB, but you can actually use a normal USB stick like this Toshiba 128GB stick. But to use this one, you're going to need one of these. It's like a little USB hub, converting USB-C to 4 USB ports, and then you'll just plug in your USB memory stick like so, and then plug this end into the Steam Deck. So I've waffled on and off. Let's jump on over to the PC and get one of these memory sticks set up so we can reinstall SteamOS on the Steam Deck once we've installed that SSD. Now we're over on the PC, you want to head to the link in the description below, because we're going to download the SteamOS recovery software. As you can see, it's this link here. Then you need to agree to the terms and then click download. Now, to make things simple, we're going to drag the image file from the zip we just downloaded and drop it on the desktop. This shouldn't take too long to extract, but I have actually sped up the footage. Now, we're actually going to use a program called Rufus to put the image on the USB stick. So we're going to select the image, and then we're going to make sure that the USB stick we've got installed is selected at the top. It's going to say that it's going to wipe everything off Are you really sure you want to wipe everything off? Yes, let's go ahead and do it. And as always, let's speed up that footage. Now, depending on the USB stick you've used, whether it's USB 2, USB 3, 3.1, it will depend on how long this process takes. For me, it took about 10 minutes. Now that's the USB stick all sorted out, it's time to take apart the Steam Deck. Here you can see, we have a nice shiny brand new Steam Deck. Now this footage is also sped up 2 times, but I will talk you through it. Now the best way to support the Steam Deck is to use the case. Put it face down on one side of the case that has the thumbstick cutouts, just so you don't damage them by leaning it on its front. Now there's 8 screws on the back of the Steam Deck. There's 4 towards the center, and there's 4 outer ones. As you can see, I'm starting in the center. Now these screws are slightly smaller than the ones on the outside, so you don't want to get them mixed up. Now here comes the tricky part. The Steam Deck has loads of clips and they're quite strong, so you need something to jam in there to pop them all out. Recommend going across the top first, and as you can see here, I'm kind of pushing it into the side where the triggers are to undo those clips as well. Now you do have to take your time when you're doing this, and as you can see, I'm pulling it closer to myself so I can see better. Now these clips do make quite a lot of noise, like a snapping noise, but that's fine, this is normal. So just keep going around, all the way around the edge of the Steam Deck, until you've completely released the back cover. And there we go, the back cover is now off. So as you can see, to the left of the fan, you'll have like a metal shield. Now the battery connection here can't actually be taken off yet. Yes, the Steam Deck's already turned off, but there's 3 screws that we need to take out to remove that heat shield or RF shield, so we can then get to the battery to disconnect it. So there we go, the heat shield's off, and now we need to disconnect the battery. Now there is a little tab you can pull, but you can also use the spudger tool to just push it out the way. I'm going to push the power button a few times to make sure it's discharged, and then we can start by taking out the screw for the SSD. Now the SSD has some kind of heat shield, RF shield wrap around it. We're going to want to keep that and put it on the new SSD. So here we can see, here's the 512 gig NVMe SSD. So if you notice, like I did, where it's just not quite fitting inside, you can actually open it up and it will still be sticky. So then just place it over the new M.2 SSD and then put the sticky back down. So it should look something like this. Then we're going to put it back in place and replace the screw. And now we're just going to do everything in reverse. We've got the SSD in, you need to connect the battery next. You might have just seen that the power light will come on for a split second and go back off, that's fine. We're going to replace the heat shield, put those 3 screws back in. Now the screw I'm doing right now did have a little silver sticker on it. Now I decided not to put it back on. I don't think it's going to make any difference at all, and I haven't experienced any quirks or bugs or any sort of issues by not putting it back. If you want to put it back, that's up to you. Now when you put the back on, remember those nasty, cracky, snappy clips? You're going to have to push it back in, and you do have to give it quite a bit of force, but you can see it will snap into place. So once everything is flush and it's all back to normal, you can then start replacing the screws. Remember, the smaller screws go in the four in the center. Now it's time to hold the volume up and push the power button. As soon as you hear the chime, you can let the power button go and let the volume button go. And this will take us into recovery mode. Now you can plug in your memory stick, whether it's USB-C or with a dongle to normal USB. So the option that you're going to want to pick here is Boot Manager. And then look for the USB stick. Mine's a Kingston, so it actually says Kingston. Now here is where you're going to need to be very patient, because it's basically booting a Linux operating system from that USB stick. So I'm going to speed up this footage and get to the point where we can actually install the SteamOS on the new 512GB M.2 SSD. Now using the right trackpad, you're going to want to highlight reinstall SteamOS and then push the right trigger. You're going to get some sort of a message saying, do you want to proceed or cancel? Again, use the right trackpad and then hit the right trigger. Once it's all completed, you'll see a message saying proceed. So what's going to happen now is the Steam Deck is going to restart. You can remove that USB memory stick and it's going to go through the setup just like it did when you first got the Steam Deck. Nice, fresh, clean install. And that's it, you're all done. Of course, you can also add a micro SD card in there to increase your storage even more. But now you have a Steam Deck with 512 gigabytes or whatever you put in yours. Now, of course, things are not going to end there for me and my Steam Deck. We're going to do loads of videos on all different things, including the performance on SteamOS games. We're going to install Windows and see how some of the other games run that are not compatible with the Steam Deck. We're also going to look at emulation because the Steam Deck is dubbed as the emulation beast. So we're going to look at emulating a few different systems like the Nintendo Switch. We're going to be looking at going through all the PlayStation games. It can actually emulate PS1, 2 and 3. And look at all the other different bits and bobs that go with it. We're also going to answer the question, can the Steam Deck in fact replace a full gaming PC setup by using a dock? Now we're not going to use the official Steam Deck dock because they're quite expensive and there is alternatives out there. And also remember, if you need any tips or support with the Steam Deck, the Nintendo Switch, or any other aspect of any other video that you've seen on the channel, you can join the official Alien Retro Gaming Discord server. Link is in the description below. Now, if you're excited about upcoming content on the Steam Deck or the Nintendo Switch, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads. I'm JP, you've been watching Alien Retro Gaming, and I'll catch you in the next one.